Hello again, dear netizens. It is I, again, the talking poop. A basic recap, I'm making an RPG for my art school senior thesis where you travel to hell to save your boyfriend from being eaten by hell dwellers. Or like just the people in hell, and the people and the creatures in hell. Today, I'd like to start off with a disaster that happened this week. I was hyped to show you guys the pixel version of all the characters, and some from multiple angles, but I did a dumb thing, and Photoshop won't undo any further than 20 times, or at least I didn't put the settings necessary for that. Also, this upload came later than I'd like, obviously. I'll put all the excuses for my late upload in the description box below for you if you are interested. So that was my dog. I'm not sure if you can hear him now, but he really likes singing to the piano. So my sister is playing piano right now and he can't stop singing and I'm like, ugh. Okay, so for the past few weeks, I've mainly been working on Dialogic. Yep. As you might know by now, I'm using Emilio's Dialogic. So someone commented asking for some inside look into Dialogic, so here it is. By default, Dialogic dialog boxes look like this, and I didn't want my game to look too visual novel-y. I wanted more of an RPG look like this. The character name and text are inside the box, and more towards the right in my version. The character portrait is just from the bust upwards and it's in front of the box. So what I did was I went into the Dialog GD script, searched for the section that I need. Emilio has really good and clear hashtag comments in the script file. So for example, if you command F to look for the character name, you'll most probably find the right section you need. And just like, once you find it, just fiddle with the code, move stuff around. Sometimes it takes surprisingly easy fixes to get the effect you want. My final thesis presentation is in 2 or 3 weeks, so I'd like to have a start screen, intro, and a short demo of the gameplay to show by then. So I'm spending a lot of my time mostly in front of the computer and my eyes are really tired. And Basil's room is where the game starts, so that's gonna be in my demo. I gave Basil a wallpaper inspired by Victorian patterns, a good armchair for the sitters whom he paints, plop in my young Dorian Pink, and like you can walk around, interact with things, and just be nosy. I use individual timelines and Dialogic for each of this. I love Emilio's Discord community, and apparently having folders for all these timelines are in the works for the next update, so crossing our fingers, because everything gets out of hand when there's too many dialogues or timelines. I also had a problem with disabling raycast and movement when the player is in dialog, so how I have it set up is this raycast is going to rotate depending on which direction the player is walking towards, and it would collide with objects that are static body 2Ds. It would be rude for the player to walk around when an NPC is talking, and also it would restart the dialog because if I press spacebar, the raycast would perpetually collide with a table, for example, and the dialog wouldn't advance because normally when you press spacebar, the dialog would continue. I tried out a couple of different ways to remedy this, including using a can walk variable or setting a pause mode, and supposedly they should all work, but my code architecture was so messy, I couldn't keep track of all the signals and all my autoloads. My autoloads had too much dependency between scripts, and I couldn't keep track of my brain, I was so frustrated. Long story short, I had an autoload scene loader that also plays a transition between scenes, and I'm not doing that anymore. That really cursed my project. But a big part of coding things is starting from scratch again. LMAO. I watched a cool video by Tutemic that was 7 hours, but some helpful netizen posted timestamps in the comment section. I will put it in the description box below. This was honestly very enjoyable and relatable and really helped me think more strategically with code. I fully expected myself to be bored out of my mind watching someone code for like an hour straight. But no, honestly, it was really fun and really funny as well. So moving forward, I am going to try to use game states for raycast and movement restriction during dialogue. I've been putting off learning about state machines and stuff because I didn't want to learn it at first, but yeah, I just have to learn it now, I guess. I also worked on some final character expressions, more memorably the sprite of Lord Henry Wotton. In the book, he was sort of like a guide to Dorian's career of evilness. When I first started the game, Henry was supposed to be evil, or sort of like an entity of evil. But as the game evolved, he sort of became this weird uncle person with weird habits who likes to talk and talk, but never walks the talk, you know? Anyway, I personally don't think hedonism is evil either, it's merely a school of thought. I did some exploration on the logo. I will post these in the Discord channel. Nothing is clicking with me yet now, but I am trying to go for a look of wittiness and humor disguised in a more serious tone, sort of like a satirical look, almost. Okay, this is a few days later. I found this handy thing by accident that could be a new addition to Photoshop because I've never used it before. It could be that I'm outdated with the new Photoshop features and stuff, but it's virgin history. It might just be for files saved on the Adobe Cloud. So basically you have all these versions of files when they are at the moments that they were saved. And I think after 60 or 30 days, they get deleted. So what a lifesaver. I restored my file. Oh my fucking God. Thank you, Photoshop. I'm sorry for cursing you so much that day. Wow. Thank you again for spending time to watch this devlog. Feel free to like or dislike this video and subscribe if you'd like to chat and stuff. Come join our Dorian Pink Discord. And yeah, bye.